Well, welcome to the Cosmic Walk. This is the first time that we've done a Cosmic Walk here at the Unitarian Universalist Congregation of Santa Fe, and I hope it won't be the last time. The Cosmic Walk is one of the very early rituals created to express the epic of evolution. And it's been around since early in the 1980s. It was actually created by Sister Miriam Therese McGillis at Genesis Farm in New Jersey. And it's been taught across the country in numerous different settings. There are the setting that I use is one that's been adapted for Unitarian Universalists. But basically, they're all the same, and we can evolve it over time as we choose. Our spiral labyrinth is 137 feet long, with every 10 feet representing a billion years. Now that gives you very roughly the age of our universe. So as we walk the timeline, we walk back in time to the very center, which is where things begin. And then as we spiral outwards, we will mark along the timeline with the various colors of thread and with candles placed at the various colors of thread, different events in the evolution of our cosmos, and then in the evolution of our planet, and then in the evolution of humankind, which really is that last 1 inch of lime green thread at the very end of our timeline. We're going to invite you to do the walking after Monroe walks the spiral the first time and kindles the Big Bang, bringing everything into being. As you, when you walk, there are votive candles behind Monroe on the little side table over there. Take one of them, walk all the way into the center, and then walk out again and stop at the next place. There's a colored band on our timeline, on our labyrinth. So you'll see there's some very long stretches where the same thing keeps happening and we don't have something specific marked. Now, we have scientists in the room. So next year when we do this, it's just fine with me if we add a whole lot more marks. Okay? So. Mystery generates wonder. Wonder generates awe. Today we take a glimpse at the beauty of our cosmic story, something of its deep mystery. It is the story of the universe. It is the story of our Earth. It is the story of humankind. It is your story and my story. In the beginning is the great mystery, the churning quantum foam of potentiality. Through the mystery, all things come to be. Not one thing has its being but through this mystery. From the great mystery, all of us came into being. From the void, from the dark, come the light and the spark. Some 13.7 billion years ago, a great ball of fire expanded outward into the creation of the universe. Space and time, shadows and light. And the universe expands. As the universe expands, it begins to cool. And after about a million years, things cool sufficiently for hydrogen and helium to bring with them new forms of matter. And the great mystery is there from the beginning in the relationship between these things.
A billion years later, galaxies come forth. Stars are born, live, and die. Larger stars in their death throes explode and become supernovas. As they blast out into the cosmos, supernovas create in their wombs the elements of life. And the great mystery is there in the creation and destruction.
Later, or 4.6 billion years ago, our grandmother star went supernova. Stars live and die, and this star gave up her life in an explosion that gave rise to our star, the star we call the sun. And the great mystery is there, in her sacrifice. Okay, Zoe, it's right here. Here you go. Okay. We need...
4.5 billion years ago, our solar system forms from the remains of the supernova explosion. The sun and a great disk of matter emerge. All the planets and other members of our solar system family. Here begins the story of what will become one blue and white pearl of a planet. The great bombardment begins. Comets and meteorites pelt the Earth's thickening crust. As it cools off, the moon is born when Earth is impacted by a Mars-side body that causes the Earth to tilt to the side, giving rise to the seasons of the year. And the great mystery is there in the cycles.
The first candle here, this one, that one, the first candle is galaxies, supernovas and galaxies, and the beginning of stars living and dying and creating all of those elements that everything else is made of. So 4.4 to 4.1 billion years ago, over hundreds of millions of years, Earth grows from dust particles to a large, hot, molten planet with a thin, rocky crust. The crust thickens and cracks, and exuberant volcanoes expel hotly agitated deep earth magma to the surface. As steam condenses over the earth, the miracle of rain and weather cycles begins. The first rains fall. Torrential rains fall on and on and on until rivers run over the land and pool into oceans. And the great mystery is there in the rains.
4 billion years ago, the rich chemical brew brings forth invisibly small creatures that we call bacteria. And the mystery is there in the first living cells.
3.9 billion years ago, bacteria run out of free food supplies. And so they invent new ways to capture energy from the sun, which they then use to create new sources of food from water and from simple minerals. In the process, however, they give off oxygen, a deadly, corrosive gas that eventually piles up in the atmosphere and threatens all life. And the great mystery is there, in the process.
Two billion years ago, oxygen-loving cells emerge. The first global environmental crisis is averted by the creativity of these tiny cellular creatures who invent a use for oxygen as they breathe it in, like we do, and use its energy. Oxygen levels continue to rise until they reach near present-day levels. These individual bacteria learn to cooperate and specialize within giant cell cooperatives. Within one cell, some creatures make food, while others invent tiny electric motors that move the colony into sunlight, where others capture the energy of the sun. The individual parts become less independent, but more secure as inseparable parts of the new wholes. These types of organisms are the same stuff of all plants and animals today, and the great mystery is there in cooperation.
A billion years ago, organisms began to eat one another in the predator-prey dance that promotes the vast diversity of life, as predators pick off the least healthy members among their prey species. And the great mystery is there again, in the diversity of emerging life.
Seven hundred million years ago, some organisms began living together in colonies, finding ways to communicate with each other using chemical messages. And the great mystery is there in community.
Six hundred million years ago, light-sensitive eye spots evolve into eyesight, and the Earth sees itself for the very first time. The first animals to evolve in the oceans are soft-bodied. And over the next 70 million years, previously naked animals protect themselves with shells. Jaws and beaks and skeletons follow suit. And the great mystery is there, in the seeing and in the protecting.
Four hundred sixty million years ago, leaving the water, animals such as worms and mollusks and crustaceans seek the adventure of breathing air, surviving weather, and raising themselves up against gravity. Algae and fungi venture ashore as well. The first plants evolve as mosses. Insects evolve with nearly weightless bodies that permit them to take to the air as the first flying animals. And the great mystery is there in the algae, the fungi, and the insects.
I need someone to, there we go, a votive for 395 million years ago. 395 million years ago, the first amphibian animals hop and lumber onto the land. They trade in their gill slits for air-breathing lungs, and they transform their fins into stubby legs, but they continue to return to the water to lay eggs. Frogs and toads and their kin come into being. And the great mystery is there with the amphibians.
Million years ago, the first forests evolve. Over generations, these forests load themselves with carbon extracted from the atmosphere, which later becomes fossilized as coal and oil. As the great forests spread, amphibians transform into pre-reptilian creatures with the grand innovation of self-contained eggs that allow them to move inland. The great age of reptiles begins. And the great mystery is there in the forests and the reptiles.
Million years ago, following the fourth and greatest mass extinction on Earth, the end of the Permian period is followed by the emergence of the dinosaurs. For 170 million years, these animals flourish. Dinosaurs, sometimes as large as 40 meters, are social animals that often travel and hunt in groups. Dinosaurs develop a behavioral novelty previously unknown in the reptile world: parental care. Some of the dinosaurs carefully bury their eggs, and they stay with their young after they hatch, nurturing them towards independence. And the great mystery is there in the dinosaurs.
Two hundred twenty-five million years ago, the first mammals, small and nocturnal, jump, climb, swing, and swim through a world of giants. Some rodent-sized insect eaters evolve lactation, enabling mothers to spend more time in the nest, keeping their young both fed and warm. And the great mystery is there in the mammals.
Million years ago, birds emerge, the direct descendants of certain dinosaurs whose foreleg bones evolved into wing bones, whose jaw bones evolved into beaks, and whose scales evolved into feathers. Far larger than the birds of today, with wingspans as large as 12 meters across. the great mystery is there in the birds.
Million years ago, flowers evolve gorgeous and overt sexual organs, making themselves irresistible to insects by way of colors, perfumes, and delightful nectars. Insects, drawn to the nectar, unknowingly transport pollen from one flower to the next, fertilizing the very plants on which they feed. The earth adorns herself magnificently and invites the sky creatures into a new dance. And the great mystery is there in the flowers.
Million years ago. Shortly after primates appear on the scene, the Cretaceous period ends with the fifth mass extinction after an asteroid 6 miles in diameter hits the Yucatan Peninsula, leading in time to a severe drop in the Earth's temperature. This marks the end of the age of the dinosaurs and the beginning of the age of mammals, the Cenozoic era. With the dinosaurs gone, the once dark and sheltered niche that small animals occupied expands. And those little creatures stride into the daylight, moving quickly to occupy as much of the planetary ecology as possible. Over the course of the next 60 million years, Earth greets rodents, whales, monkeys, horses, cats, dogs, antelope, gibbons, grazing animals, orangutans, gorillas, elephants, chimpanzees, camels, bears, pigs, baboons, and the very first humans. It is the age of mammals, and the great mystery is there in the destruction and in the creation. And now we're down to that last inch. And I think we have 8 candles left. So we need, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7? We need 7 people to walk. So you can walk together. Let's get 7 people with candles walking together in the labyrinth. You can be a little bit ahead of them. It's okay. You're going to cover 4 million years. So you can spread out a little bit. Slow pace would be fine.
4 million years ago, hominids leave the forest, stand up, and walk on 2 legs. The savanna offers the challenges and opportunities for these early creatures to evolve into humans. They move over the surface of the earth, eventually spreading themselves over all 6 continents.
A 100,000 years ago, modern humans finally emerged. Language, shamanic and goddess religions, and art become integral with human life, and spirituality emerges.
11,000 years ago, agriculture is invented. Humans begin to shape the environment, deciding which species shall live and which shall die.
Five thousand years ago, the classical religions emerged. Hinduism, Confucianism, Judaism, Buddhism, Christianity, and Islam.
250 years ago, scientists begin to calculate the age of the Earth. And humans try to understand how old the Earth is through empirical observation.
A scant 70 years ago, empirical evidence of an expanding universe is discovered. 33 years ago, science find evidence of the origin of the universe as they see the primordial flaring forth.
And just 30 years ago, the Earth is seen as a whole from space by human eyes. The Earth becomes complex enough to witness her own integral beauty. And the great mystery is there in the universe becoming conscious of itself.
Today, the story of the universe is being told as our sacred story, and that first flaring forth continues, and the great mystery is here, in this moment, in each of us, and in all of us together. Amen. Shalom, namaste, oho, and blessed be. May the story continue for a long, long time.